Hi, today I'm going to show you how I clean my silver jewelry. Now you're just going to need a few items that you can find around the house. The first one is some baking soda. The next is some aluminum foil, and then you're going to need either a cup or a pot and some boiled water. So this method can be used on either pure sterling silver jewelry or silver plated items. So this can include cutlery or, you know, serving dishes, whatever it may be. But keep in mind that if the item is sterling silver plated, it's not going to be stamped 925, which is the sterling silver stamp. And also, if the item is taking on kind of a more brassy or orange coppery kind of tone, that's probably a sign that the plating has worn off, not that it is just tarnished. So take a good look at the item before you start trying to clean away at it if it isn't pure sterling silver. But you're going to notice that the item will take on kind of a dark silvery, go figure, a dark gray kind of tone if it is just tarnished. So to start off, you're going to get a cup and a piece of aluminum foil that's big enough to kind of fit the bottom of whatever kind of pot or cup you're using. So you're just going to stick that in there. I put the shiny side up. I don't think it really matters. So that goes at the bottom. You're going to put about a tablespoon of baking soda in there. Just dump it in. I'm kind of pretty liberal with my amount of product. I'm sure you can find somewhere online that gives you a very specific amount, but I'm pretty much just using a cup of water and a tablespoon of baking soda, and then just a small piece of aluminum foil. And then you're going to put some jewelry items in there. I have like a little ring, and then a necklace. And these aren't extremely tarnished, but this necklace is a chain, and chains are very hard to clean with a polishing cloth, so this method works really well for that. I'm gonna drop in the necklace, and then I'm also going to put in a charm bracelet. So then you're going to grab your boiled water, and if you're doing this on a stove, you can actually drop the items in when the water is boiling, like has come to a bubbling boil, but I just previously boiled this in a kettle. I find that it works well for me this way. You're just going to pour the water in, and then you're going to let it sit for a few seconds. There's no real like rhyme or reason to how long it's going to take, but you're just going to kind of move the items around. You can use a dingle hopper or a fork if you don't catch the Little Mermaid reference. So the water starts to smell. Stirring it up. The water will take on a weird smell and can start to get a bit gray. Now my water has cooled down a little bit, so it's not going to be as warm. But after a few seconds, you're going to, oh my god, it stinks so much. You're going to take out your items. I'm just going to give it a few more seconds. So you can't really tell in this cup because the items aren't that tarnished, but the water will start to get a bit gray. Here we go. Okay, now I'm going to just check on my necklace. The fork is going to help you pull out the items so that you don't burn yourself. Let's see how it goes. Okay. So you're going to want to take out the items. They will be very hot. My water isn't so hot anymore. And then you're just going to want to dry them off with a regular towel. And I find that this is the easiest way to actually clean jewelry pieces. I'll take out the other two. I'll put more in-depth pictures in a blog post of how it works. But after a few seconds, you're just going to want to scoop out your items, leave them to dry, and they're going to be much shinier and definitely less tarnished. And the water will take on that kind of gray tone because it is dissolving that tarnished coating off of your silver item. So if you just need kind of a quick clean of your jewelry and it's not a really difficult chain to get into, you can just use a regular silver polishing cloth. You can find these at most jewelry stores. And then To prevent tarnishing from happening again, you're going to want to keep your jewelry in their little dust bags, or you can get these really handy non-tarnish tabs. I got these at a craft store, and these are the 3M Tarnish Shield. So I put one of these little pieces of black paper into a plastic bag and seal it up, and that will completely eliminate tarnishing. Mind you, these tabs will kind of lose their effectiveness after about 6 months, so just keep that in mind. But what happens in this sealed bag is the oxygen, the little like pieces of paper will absorb the oxygen, so the item will not be exposed to oxygen, because the tarnishing happens when your silver item is exposed to, you know, oxygen and isn't being rubbed against the skin. If your item is kind of constantly being worn, the tarnish won't appear as dark. But if you kind of just leave a bracelet out in the open for a few months, you will notice that it will take on that dark gray tarnish tone. So to eliminate that, plastic bag, with or without the tarnish tape, it'll definitely make a difference regardless if it's kind of sealed in a bag or in a dust bag. So that's about it. I hope this video was helpful. Thank you so much for watching and enjoy the rest of your day. Bye.